Evening. Let's start. So today's topic is again back to VMware snapshots. So when you are using these snapshots, any idea? First of all, let me clear you a few things. Backup and snapshot, both are different. Don't confuse and don't mix up the concepts.
Okay.
Never ever use snapshot is a backup technology, but backup technology uses the snapshot technology. Any backup technology you take in VMware, okay, that is dependent on the snapshot technology, and it will take the snapshot and do the data transport. Okay, but snapshot is not at all a backup. Please remember. Clear? Vivek, that's what you were saying earlier.
Yeah.
Snapshot means what it will do. Let me explain you a very simple way. You have ESXi host, and it is connected to one of the SAN storage, right? Or one of the SAN data store. I'm not talking about any local storage or something. Just imagine you have some SAN storage. And what I did, I have created one virtual machine. What all the files that it will have? VMDK, VMSN, VMSD, VMX, log, NVRAM, right? VMX auxiliary, and what else? Any other files? Let me check what all the files that we have. Go to virtual machine, right? So to storage, SSD, browse. Let me see. Yeah, Active Directory. You have these many files. I'm sorry. How many? We have around these many files. Three. Twelve plus 18. 19 files are there. Combination of all these things. VMDK, okay, and some hash log swap and two swap files. That's what I missed here. One more thing is these are the files. Okay. Now what you will do, you will simply go to virtual machine. Click, take a snapshot. I don't want memory. Okay, snap one. Give some description. You just click on take a snapshot. What it will do? So it has these many files, right? It has these many files. Where these files are saved? On this data store. Okay. On this data store, all these files were saved. What it will do, it will freeze these VMDK files. What is VMDK file? Quickly. What it contains? Hello?
Data, disk, data.
Okay, Installed. Right? OS. Your disk volumes. Your disk volumes on the front end. Okay, so the moment you right click and click on take a snapshot, click OK. What it will do, it will lock all the VMDK files, and it will create same number of another set of VMDK files. In the sense, if I have a three VMDK files here, it will lock all the three and it will create three more files. Okay. And if customer is saving some data, let's imagine I took a snapshot at 9:55 a.m. 9:55 a.m. So after 9:55, whatever the data that customer is saving on that particular server or modifying on that particular server, everything will be saved on these three VMDK files because the original files are in read-only mode. Okay, in that situation, what you're saying, if I'm saying a customer is inserting some data, no, as a patching team, you are installing some patches on it. Remember, 10 o'clock in the morning, you have a CRQ scheduled. Okay, till 2 p.m. in the afternoon. That's a window. Okay, during that time, what you're doing, you're installing some patches on top of the system and you're rebooting frequently. So what happens? Whatever the patch that you're installing, they will not go and save it on these hard disk. Actually, they'll whatever the data that you are saving, they will come and save on this VMDK files. Okay, so you followed the process, whatever the patching steps are there, you followed and everything is done and you finally rebooted the server and informed to customer saying, can you please check the server or check the application and confirm, because I'm done with the patching task. So around 1:30, let's say around 1:30, you have asked customer for validation. So what do you expect? You have two possible things. Once patching is successful, server is up and running. Second, patching is failed, application is not working. These are the two possible ways that customer can give and a reply. Is there anything else that you can expect?
No.
If patching is successful, he will say everything is good, go ahead and close the change. If a patching is failed, application is not coming up, then he will say nothing is working, please do the needful. That's what he says. Now what you will do if a patching is failed, you start uninstalling the patches, reboot it, uninstall it, reboot it, and remove the registry entries, reboot it. You do all these things. Still, if you are unable to recover the machine within half an hour, what we will do? There's a problem, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now you are saying if you are taking a backup, if you are taking a backup, backup means you are copying this VM and place it in somewhere else, some other place. Now, if you want to restore it back, the restoration rate is 60 GB per hour. 60 GB per hour. The VM size is 2 TB. You have half an hour left. Do you think it is possible to restore 2 TB in half an hour? Hello.
Hello.
You understand my question?
Yes.
Do you think it is possible? Yes or no? That's it.
No.
Right?
Afterwards.
Yeah, that's what my question is. Okay, if you are not able to correlate yourself, please ask the questions. Half an hour, you cannot restore the machine, right? So backup is not a feasible solution. Backup is not at all a feasible solution. What snapshot will do? Snapshot has taken on this particular machine. What it has done, it is logged all the original files and it has created some temporary files. Okay. So if a patching is successful, imagine first condition, if patching is successful, whatever the data that is saved on these three files, is valid or invalid?
It's valid.
Valid, right? At 9:55, you took a snapshot. After 9:55, whatever the data from 10 o'clock in the morning to 1:30 in the afternoon, whatever the data modifications that you have done, everything is captured under these three files. So these three files are valid. So if a patching is successful, customer is saying everything is good, what you have to do, you have to copy this data onto original files. Okay, and you have to delete these files and you need to unlock these files. Right, then the machine will function as it is, like an original server. This process you call it as consolidate snapshot. You getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay. Now customer is complaining, saying your patching is failed. My application is not working. In that case, what you can do, you can simply ignore these files. You can simply ignore these three files and unlock these original files and power on the VM, your machine will start as it is. It is at 9:55. So 2 o'clock, if you restart the machine, you will see exactly the same machine when you took a snapshot, 9:55. No patches, no modifications, nothing. It will not show anything after 9 o'clock, or 9:55. Okay, what you have to do, simply select the snapshot, delete it, and then restart the machine. It will automatically start how it looks like at 9:55, and send an email to customer saying we have the process is called revert snapshot. So you just send an email to the customer saying we have reverted the snapshot. Can you please check now, because the patches are having some issue, or one of the patches creating some problem, that we will do it leisurely. For now, I will revert the snapshot and I will power on the VM. The machine will run as it is, how it looks like at 9:55 in the morning. Please check it and confirm, so that you can revert the changes, or you can discard the 5 hours of work within a fraction of seconds with the snapshot. You understand what I'm trying to explain?
Yes.
Okay. So once the snapshot has been reverted, these files are of no use. Simply delete the snapshot. Okay. So what is the last step? Delete the snapshot. Create the snapshot. Perform the task what you want to perform. That may be upgrade, that may be a patching, that may be a modification, that may be copying data here and there, or that may be changing some permissions on the application, whatever it may be. Okay, depends on you. Once everything is done, you have two possible ways, yes or no. If it is yes, consolidate and delete. If it is no, revert and delete. That's it. The snapshot will go and save. It will go and save in the same data store. But what is the recommendation? If I have a 2 TB VM, do I require a 2 TB additional space on data store? Hello.
No.
How much then? My virtual machine size is 2 TB. How much free space that you require on data store to take a snapshot? Remember, if it is a normal virtual machine, you need at least 5% of free space of this data store. If the data store is 2 TB, you need to make sure at least 5% of the free space is available. If it is a I'm sorry, not a highly high transaction server like SQL or any other application server, you need to have 10% free space for a snapshot. And how long you retain the snapshot? Usually snapshots will be retained for 1 day or 2 days, max 3 days, 72 hours. Normally 48 hours is best practice. If something goes wrong, you are following up something with the customer and he's still checking something, he's trying to fix something, okay? So that you can hold the snapshot for 48 hours or in some of the cases, 3 days, 72 hours, it's okay. But not months on months. You'll never ever keep the snapshot for a month. Clear?
Why? What it will do?
Sorry.
Cannot keep the...
That is not the best practice, I'm saying. If you want to keep it, at risk is yours. Snapshot is a temporary repository. Temporary means 2 days or 1 week, not for years and years. Clear?
So if we keep the snapshot, if we forgot to delete it,
correlate, my friend, correlate with business logic. What you are trying to achieve by keeping the snapshot? Patching is done, success or failure. That's it. Simply playing with the VMware, you want to keep the snapshot for a month and months. Yes, it will be there. You can keep it for months and months. Not an issue. But if you look at the business point of view, I have a thousands of virtual machines. Okay, and you are keep on creating a snapshot for each and every machine. How much space that the system should contain? All the system support on the back. Are you looking at those things? How much extra space that you are using, and customer is not paying anything for those spaces, because snapshot you will not bill for customer. You will not bill for customer. You are giving it for free for 1 day or 2 days, and you are saying I will want to keep the snapshot for each and every virtual machine for a week. Why? Why you are wasting so much of space in the stores? That is another concern. And moreover, the business requirement is 1 or 2 days, then why you are keeping the snapshot for a month? So you gave me the justification, then I'm okay to keep it. If you don't have a justification, we will straight away delete the snapshots after 48 hours, irrespective of what machine that they are using. Tell me, you're saying something?
I was just saying, if somebody forgets to delete the snapshot.
If they forgot to delete, you have some scripts to pull out the reports. Okay. As a L1 monitoring, or as a L2 admin, or as a L3 admin, your morning daily health check should check or should validate these things. You'll have some reports, you'll have some RB tools reports and stuff. You go and check. Do you have any snapshots that are sitting ideal and no one knows really? Okay, then identify them, contact the right person and ask them to delete, or ask them to give a justification. Clear? Hello. Let's test it. How it works? Let's test it. So I have one virtual machine. This is my virtual machine. Okay. So I have those many. Oh, it's okay. This is current state. How many files are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 files are there. Please remember. Okay. On the desktop, 7 files are there. Now I have this VM. Now. Okay. I have this VM. and the time is 7:42. Okay, my change starts at, imagine, 8 p.m. 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Okay, after 10 p.m. I need to hand over the server to the customer. So what I will do, I will take a snapshot of this server. Okay, I am saying when once I took a snapshot, you will see the number of files will vary. Let me log into the ESXi host. I'm not even logging into vCenter and all because I don't require the vCenter today. So let me 192.168.1.151. Okay, let me change settings a little bit. If a font is visible, please let me know. If it is not visible, please let me know. Visible? Font is visible now? Everyone?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So now we will use CLI ls cd slash vm images, ls, not the VM images, sorry, cd vmfs volumes, on which volume the machine is saved, SSD. It's okay, sensitive, SSD. Okay, ls, lc, couple of VMs here. Okay, cd US. What is my Active Directory? This is my Active Directory machine, right? So go to that machine. You are now inside that machine, ls-ltr. Now, if you look at, these are the files. Okay, so twenty-one files are there. Okay, and if I say vmdk, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 vmdk files are there here. Please watch it carefully. And if you look at the sizes, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's okay, four different files, and they are of different sizes. And there are another set of four different files. You see the data size is bytes only. 517 bytes, 569 bytes. Okay, but let's go to storage on the front end, GUI. Go to data store, browse data store, and where is my Active Directory? AD01. Okay, now see the VMDK files. No, nothing. One VMDK, and three VMDK on top, one VMDK here. Only four VMDK files are there. But on the Unix side, if you go and check, eight VMDK files are there. How come? Basically, you know Windows shortcut. Have this folder, right? So what I will do, send to desktop shortcut. So normally how I will access, I'll come here and go to this PC and C drive class, it'll go here, right? So I'll simply open a shortcut, you'll be able to access it. Then what is this and what is this? This is actual folder, this is shortcut folder. Agree or disagree? Okay. Okay. Similarly, don't think too much. If flat dot vmdk, if a flat dot vmdk is there, treat this as actual folder or actual file. And the normal vmdks are there with the pointers, very less size. These are pointer files. If you want to Google it, identify the technical terms, it's fine. But if you want to remember, the easiest way is the actual data holding is these files, and these are the pointer files. Fair enough. Now, if I take a snapshot on the front end GUI, on the front end GUI, four files will be locked. Another set of four files will be created. That's fine. On the front end, I am not bothered about front end. Anyway, I am logging into Unix, right? So I'm logging into Linux prompt. So I will count the files here. I'll check the files here. Let's follow this. So this is how many files was? 24. Total number of files, 24 snapshot. Okay. So for snapshot, right? So what I will do, I will go to virtual machine and come on. I'll go to virtual machine. Very slow. Snapshot, take a snapshot. I'm just ignoring this memory. It will create one more extra file. That's it. RAM dump it will create. Nothing additional. But our testing, it's fine. For testing, it's not an issue. Snapshot one, take a snapshot. Done. That's it. Fraction of seconds. Now I'll run the same command. Copy all the files and I'll paste it here. Initially, how many? 24. Now, how many files you got? How many files you got? How many additional files it got created? Tell me. Nine additional files. Out of nine only? Yeah, nine. Out of nine, eight additional files, eight disk files. If you see VMDK, all are VMDK files. Now you see flat.vmdk is there and delta.vmdk is there. And flat four delta files, four flat files. Okay. And for four flat
VMSL.
Hang on. Four flat files or actual data files, they're locked. All the four flat files are locked, and the respective VMDK files, the shortcut files, also locked. Okay, now you have another set of files with the additional numbering. You see eight numbers: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight new files got created, and one is delta. Another one is just a pointer. Delta file is the newly created disk file, temporary file, and their pointers. Combining eight new files and one snapshot file, VMSN. Okay, what VMSN will have? VMSN will have at what time the snapshot has been taken, and what all the files included in the snapshot. I included all these files, for example, out of all these files, it will remember all the information. And if you look at VMSD, snapshot descriptor is updated. It is also updated. If you look at most of these files were saved or modified 1419. Okay, what is the date now? 1422. Okay, when I powered on a machine, I powered on a machine around 1345. I powered on a machine around 1345 means half an hour before I powered on the machine. That time some of the files got modified, but when I took a snapshot, see, these are the files got modified. Agree? Hello? Clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, if you look at the previous file, VMSN, VM, there is no file called VMSN here. Okay, this is after the snapshot. After the snapshot, 9 new files out of 9, 8 disk files and 1 snapshot file called VMSN. Okay. And if you look at, there is one more file called VMSD. VMSD is snapshot descriptor. Snapshot descriptor will hold the information about the snapshot. Okay. VMSD is 736 bytes. If you go back before the snapshot, VMSD must be 0. You look at the VMSD somewhere. Find something. Yeah, VMSD 0. Understood? Normally VMSD is 0 when you took a snapshot. SD is updated with description of this. This is updated with all the configuration what the snapshot has taken. Now if I put a new data, where this data will go and save? If I put a new data into the server, where these files will go and save? It will be in a delta files, or if it will be in a flat files, where it will go? Whether it will be in delta or it will be in a flat file. Quickly. Hello.
Flat file.
Flat file is original file. I said flat files are logged. Clear? For that reason I asked you. So I said flat.vmdk files were logged at in this example, I took a snapshot at 7:42. At this time, all flat.vmdk files are logged. They are locked. So now after this snapshot, whatever the new data that you will save, that will be saved in delta.vmdk. If you want to check it out, let me minimize this and go to demo or go to downloads and try to copy this VMDK file. How much size? 340 MB. Just copy this file and put it on desktop. I'm copying some data into the server. Imagine you are doing some patching. You are installing some patches. Now you are copying the patch file. After this snapshot, you are modifying something inside the server. Remember. Copy. Done. One additional file got copied. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 files, remember. Okay, now I have copied some data into the server. Whatever the data that I have copied, where this will go and save, as per my knowledge, delta files must be updated. One of the delta file must be updated. See, zero delta file, this is one delta file, this is another delta file, this is another. You see the number of this. You see this number? Remember this number. Let me take duplicate session. Just want to show you. I don't want to rerun it. I'll go to here, cd/vmfs volumes /ECUSPRAD. Okay, now I'm inside this directory. Clear. Now what I will do? ls-ltr. Now you see VMDK file, it got changed. C drive VMDK file is this. Okay, when it is changed, look at 1427. Previously 1419. This is the size. 001.vmdk. 001.vmdk. Rest of the ones, _1, _2, _3. These are not changed because I haven't put any data inside D drive or E drive something. So what I will do, I'll go and put some data on D drive. Then this file or one of these three files must change. Can we check? Okay. Let's go to the server and copy this file, copy this file and put inside E drive, put inside E drive. Now run the same command once again, one of the VMDK file, _1, _2, _3. One of this file must change. ls-ltr _1 has been changed. See, _1 VMDK file has been changed. Rest of the two files were not changed. If you want to see, these two files will also change when you put a new data in those drives. Okay, when you put a new data in those files. Now go and check, all the files got changed. Delta file, this is also changed. _1 delta file changed. _2 delta file changed. _3 delta file is not changed. Why? It also must change. Okay, let's see. Clear. And yeah, it is also changed. Delta file, 2.delta file, 3.delta file, and 001.delta file. Delta, highlight the delta files. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the four files got changed now around 1429. Means whatever the new data that you are saving, that data is being saved over here. None of these files are got updated. See, these files are logged around this time, or these files were untouched. Then, understood so far?
Yes.
Okay. Now imagine. Go back. So I've done something till 10 p.m. Sorry, yeah, 10 till 10 p.m. Now I have rebooted a server. Imagine I have rebooted the server and notified to customer. If I inform to customer saying my patching is done, can you please check? If he check and give the green signal. Imagine he checked and he gave the green signal. Means what? Whatever the data that is saved on these delta files, this is valid data. So what you have to do, you have to go and run the consolidation and then delete this snapshot. So what happens? This delta file data will go and save in flat files. Okay. And these files will be deleted and
Hello.
Sunny.
Network का issue है क्या कुछ?
Hello.
Hello.
Am I audible?
Yes, now sir. Audible.
Now.
Okay, fine. So what I'm saying, I will go and run the consolidation. Once the consolidation is done, it will copy the data from these delta files and it will save on these flat files, and these files will disappear, and that VMSN file is there, no? That will also go away. Clear? Let's test this. So right click, snapshot, consolidate disk. That's it. Disk, VM disk consolidation is done. That's it. Right click, snapshots, manage snapshots. Select the snapshot, delete all snapshots. Delete all snapshots. Let's see. Yeah, snapshot has been deleted. Okay. Yes. Some consolidation is running on the back end. That is the reason. Now, delete snapshot is done. Go back to the server and go back to the machine. The data is there. Whatever the data that you have copied, it is there. Now, you go back to the Unix prompt and run the same command. You will see all the files are gone. Node VM, delta.vmdk, no VMSN, nothing. Now copy. How many files are there? Copy. Audible, hello.
Yes.
Okay. And snapshot. After. Snapshot. Consolidation and delete. You see, that's it. All the files are now back on track. Now you see these files are changed. Flat.vmdk files, they are changed. Flat.vmdk files are changed. Now you see all the data has been loaded into flat.vmdk and the delta files got disappeared. This process you call it as consolidate and delete. Understood? There's no downtime. There's no downtime. Server is running normally. So what I will do, I will delete these files again. Let me delete this. Okay, I have all this data here, right? Empty recycle bin. Fine. So now I have the machines back on track. Everything is working normal. So what I will do, I will go back to ESXi host. Select the VM. Take one more snapshot. Come on. Take one more snapshot. Snapshot 2. Okay. For revert this time, we will do snapshot revert. Okay, take a snapshot, done. Now go back to the Unix once again and run the command again. You will see 001 delta underscore 1 delta underscore 1 delta all the files, but you see snapshot number 2 and VMSD. Where is this VMSD file? Please try to find out the VMSD. See the file. So again all the files got changed and again flat.vmdk files got logged. These files logged at 1435 and new files created at 1436. Now what I will do, I will follow the same procedure. I'll copy this file and I'll paste it in desktop. Now what I will do, imagine another scenario is, what I'm doing, same virtual machine, I took a snapshot again 7:42 and I have a patching at 8 till 10 p.m. So I took a snapshot. Now patching is in progress. The final status will check. Now data is still copying, means patching is still running. Done, almost done. Now imagine patching is done. Okay, now you inform to customer. You inform to customer. He is saying there is some issue. Okay, patching is failed. Okay, if a patching is failed, what you will do? You'll simply revert the snapshot and delete the snapshot. That is what you have to do. Okay, if you revert the snapshot, the moment you revert the snapshot, what happens? Machine will be rebooted. Okay, and listen carefully. You have a flat dot files here and you have a delta files here. Okay, when you revert it, it will ignore these files and it will unlock this, and the machine will be started with this file. Okay, these files are ignored during the reboot. So machine will start with this and you will get the machine as it is, how it looks like at 7:42. That's okay. After that, delete a snapshot. These delta files will be deleted. Understood? In previous example, the delta file data is inserted into flat file data and keep on working. In this case, delta file data is ignored here and normal flat files will be unlocked without any changes and machine will run as it is, like how it looks like at 7:42, and customer will use the application. After that, you will delete the snapshot. How to do that? Let's see. So imagine now if I revert the snapshot, you will lose this file. Rest of the files must be there, because all these files are part of snapshot. So after the snapshot, I took this file, right? I have copied this file and I have tried to install it. Imagine, so this file will go away after revert the snapshot. So how to do that? Let's go back to the console, right click, snapshot, restore snapshot, or snapshot manage and select restore snapshot. Current snapshot state of the machine will be lost unless it is saved in a snapshot. Restore snapshot to, no, restore. That's it. Close. Now you see machine is powered off. Snapshot has been successfully restored and the machine is powered off. If you power on, it is disconnected. Okay. If you power on, machine will on normally. And you go back and check, you still have those delta files and all. Delta files are there. All the delta files are there. But you see, this file is unlocked now. This file is unlocked now. And machine is running with normal files. These are empty, useless files. So what you can do, you can go back to the console. Snapshot, delete all snapshots. Close. All virtual machine snapshots were successfully deleted. And go to snapshots, manage snapshots, no snapshots at all. Or now go back to machine, ls-ltr. You see, delta files are gone. Your snapshot file is gone. Most of these files are gone. Okay. And you go to the machine. Still not powered on. It is still loading. Yeah, it's powered on now. Okay. That will not, because I connected from the different machine, right? So you'll not get the MSTSC window once again. It's okay. Let me log into the console and show you. On the desktop, the file will be disappear. Okay, so let me go inside the desktop. You see, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. That another file is gone because when you revert the snapshot, it will ignore the changes you have done after the snapshot. Right? Your machine is back as it is, how it looks like at 7:42. So what happens? What happens when you are doing a specific task in a specific duration? During that time, you want to protect your machine from unwanted downtimes. You are actually planning for 2 hours downtime. You are actually planning for some work, some maintenance work for 2 hours. But due to some reason that went wrong and it took 2 days to recover. Understood? If you want to avoid such kind of things, snapshot will help you quickly. Okay. So technically, where there is a requirement of quick RTO. RTO. In I. What is RTO? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, the question is recovery time objective. Recovery time objective means if something goes wrong, how much time it will take to recover the service? Okay, your actual server is down. Okay, how much time that you take to recover that server? That is your RTO. If your backup and recovery systems are there, you want to restore the data, the RTO is 60 GB per hour. If your data is 1 TB, so around 14 to 15 hours is the RTO. Okay, now tell me, are you going to use backup and recovery or a simple snapshot? Your snapshot RTO is less than a minute. You can recover your machine from unwanted downtimes in a less than a minute. Now tell me, which one you prefer, your backup or your snapshot?
Snapshot.
Okay, now another question is, the Vivek, what you're saying, another concept you're saying, you want to keep the, I have ESXi host, I have one virtual machine, and the virtual machine data is saved in data store, and you are saying I want to take a snapshot of this and keep it in the data store for a long time, for a month. What you're trying to achieve with this? For a month. Okay, if something goes wrong, you revert it, you will lose 1 month data. Are you ready to face it? That's a disadvantage. Okay, another thing is, you put a snapshot here. If data store goes bad, your actual machine is gone and your snapshot data is also gone. Then what, how you will recover it? In this situation, your backup will come into picture. Backup is altogether separate system. It will take entire system backup and it will save it here. So if something goes wrong with the data store or ESXi host or machine crashed, you want to record the machine, entire machine back, then recover it from backup so that you will get your machine back along with the customer data. But these backups will run every night at 8 p.m. Every night at 8 p.m. means I took a backup today. And again, tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, the backup will run. If tomorrow evening, 7 p.m., the server is crashed, okay, only the way is you can recover the machine previous day 8 o'clock. So 24 hours is your RPO means recovery point objective. Recovery point objective means if something goes wrong, okay, what kind of data and how far you can go back and do the recovery. Okay, so let's go with that. Go back. RPO in RPO. So RTO, if imagine very interesting terms, if you can correlate yourself. Something happened at this time. Okay, something happened at this time. So from this time onwards, how much time you will take to recover the system? That is RTO, how much time it will take. Okay, but if something goes wrong here, how much time you can go back and bring the data? RPO is 24 hours. If today the server is crashed, I can go back to yesterday's 8 o'clock and bring the machine back to here in 15 hours. 15 hours means your RPO is 24 hours, your RTO is 15 hours. Understood? Or any confusion or any questions?
Understand.
Vivek?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Okay, so in this, if you want quick RTO, less than a minute, okay, less than a minute. Okay, sorry, less than a minute, or how will represent? Quick RTO, let's say, okay. Quick RTO, less than a minute. Use snapshot. Okay, and greater RPOs, greater recovery points, and from disaster, use backup that has little high RTO, maybe 1 or 2 hours, or 1 or 2 hours, or maybe 1 day, depending on the data size. Okay, so what is next? Tomorrow we will see how you can take a backup of any specific virtual machine. If something goes wrong, how you can do the recovery. That part we will discuss tomorrow.
Okay,
sir. Any questions up to this in snapshot? Vivek?
No, sir.
Vivek, you have any questions? No?
No, sir.
All right, yeah, let me stop here. We'll catch up tomorrow again to test backup and recovery.